Hello there, welcome back. Thank you to everybody who left comments last week on the video, which is all about graphic novels. Quite a wide range of graphic novels, so I was very pleased to see that in the comments below there were people who were interested in all three books that I had to give away, and indeed the ones that I couldn't give away. There's such a wide range of graphic novels that are published by Jonathan Cape. It's just very exciting. If you like graphic novels, just to see the range that's available. And there's even more coming this year. There's books that I don't actually have physical copies of yet to show you. But I promise you, later in the year, I'll do another graphic novel haul and show you more of what's to come. But I did have copies of each of those three books that are available now to give away. So, Winning the Red Virgin is In Red. Winning Stan and Nan is Tina Alex. And Winning Paradise Lost is A Strange Girl's Mind. Congratulations, all three of you. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. Send me your post addresses and I'll get those books off to you as soon as I can. The other two books are coming later in the year, so I can't give them away. But keep your eyes peeled. I'll be doing another video about them soon, I'm sure. Now, this week, I'm going to talk about a novel, a piece of fiction. And I'm particularly keen to talk about it because not only is it great, but I think it engages with something which I don't see an awful lot of fiction about. And I think that's kind of strange because when you turn on the news, maybe not recently so much because the British political system has gone so completely crazy over the last few weeks that that has dominated the news. But usually when you turn on the news, you hear about a terrorist bombing or a bombing somewhere in the world almost every day. And in fact, I think the fact of the matter is that we don't hear about, of course, all the bombings that happen. We tend to hear about the ones that affect British citizens or Western democracies or things like that. And we don't know that, of course, it's several bombings happening every day around the world for various reasons. It's not even a particularly new thing, but it's certainly a huge thing. And why is there not more fiction that deals with terrorism, with bombings, and with everything that goes around those sort of two subjects? Enter this novel from Karan Mahajan called The Association of Small Bombs. It's a fascinating book, and he's a fascinating man. And after finishing the book, I had lots of things going around my head. And so I managed to put some of those questions to him, and I'll put a link below to the interview, which is on the Vintage website. And you can see there that he's a very intelligent man, and he's got some very interesting ideas about why fiction, and even non-fiction, hasn't dealt particularly well with the idea of terrorism, with the idea of bombings, and the sort of fictional response to that. And I think this book does it very well, and for all sorts of reasons. It looks at a bombing in India, and what we do is to see that happen very, very much at the beginning of the book, and it's a bit like a bomb going off. You know, the narrative sort of fractures and goes off in different trajectories, and we follow the trajectories of the different characters. So two brothers and their friend are in a market when a bomb explodes, and the two brothers are killed and their friend survives. And we follow him as he leaves the scene, and we follow him and his family dealing with the guilt of survival, which is a really interesting topic. We then, of course, follow the family of the brothers who have been killed and see them dealing with grief. But we don't just leave it there. We also discover more about the people who are behind these bombs. We meet bomb makers. We discover more about how these men have come together, what motivates them, how easy it is to become radicalized for whatever reason. And there are lots of different reasons in this book. It's not just simply about sort of political or religious motivation. It's to do with the very subtle things that might happen in the male psyche that might lead you to act out in a certain way. And that's one of the fascinating strands of this book, to look at the very small things that could happen and the ways in which men who have become maybe emasculated in some way or pushed down, or there is a reason for them to act out in this way. And Mahajan does a brilliant, does a really good job of sort of looking at those things without too much judgment, but just sort of presenting these characters. You do become very involved in these characters. And the even-handedness is very impressive as well, because it's important, I think, when you're looking at something like this, not to kind of go goody, baddie, just to look at these people and to try and understand a bit more about the situation by getting the and so I think, again, he does that very well. And this novel involves India, but also involves America, and it involves very different characters. We also get to look at the Indian justice system. Is it important to get the right person for a crime, or just the right kind of people, the people that you know are involved in this kind of thing? How important is that idea of justice to the parents of people who have been bereaved? can they ever get justice? There are just lots of things raised by this. So I do implore you to have a look at that interview with Karan Mahajan, because he's very brilliant with his answers. But of course, I implore you even more to read the book, because I think it's very well done and it will raise questions for you. And so I don't know, that kind of stimulating read I find very, I was going to say enjoyable, maybe that's the wrong word, but I just, it's good to have your brain stimulated, because you may not agree with some of the things that you read, and that's just as useful as agreeing with something. So yeah, there you go. That's The Association of Small Bombs by Karan Mahajan. I have two copies to give away, so please do make sure that you are subscribed and leave comments below. However, I will not be notifying winners next week, because next week on the vlog, I'm going to be doing a very different video. I'm going to do one of those horrible things where I sort of tease you and don't tell you what it is. But let me just assure you, it's going to be a very different type of video. It was a lot of fun to do. It involves somebody else from you know, the BookTube world. And so therefore, there won't be an announcement of winners, but I'll pick up the following week, which will be the last week of the vlog before I go away on holiday for a couple of weeks. So enjoy it whilst you can, because there'll be a little gap. But anyway, next week's video is going to be well worth tuning in for. But do leave comments below if you're interested in receiving and winning copies of The Association of Small Bombs. So there you go. That is all for this week. I will see you next week. Take care.